the Brig Suicide. Committing suicide was a crime until 1961, centuries before then, specifically in the end of the Victorian era towards the beginning of the Edwardian period. Those who did commit suicide were thought to have held guilt or some wrongdoings happen within the person's social network. The consequences of whatever a person has done to take their own life must be too great for them not to live with their disgrace. Well, that is one theory. John Neal discovered a body hanging in a home on Coney Court in Brig. The corpse was that of George Draper, who worked as a greengrocer. George owed a lot of money, and he knew no matter how hard he tried, he would never be able to pay his debt. George was found to have double wrapped the rope around his neck, inside the garden shed. Dr. Goodman, who had known George for many a year, inspected George's body. George's garden would have been dark at the time of the hanging, as it was hidden away from all the main streets. George must have prepared not only with the timing, but with the measurements too. A box was seen close by to the corpse, and the feet were barely off the floor. John was asked by the doctor about the body of George. All John could reply was that George liked to have a drink sometimes. When his wife, Mrs. Draper, was asked the same question, his wife admitted that George was expecting creditors just before Christmas time. Also, Mrs. Draper said, George had not been seen since 8 o'clock that evening, and George had seemed down and depressed all day. George's wife also mentioned that he had been sober all day. Mrs. Draper also stated, it was strange for George to open up as so, but I listened as he was explaining he would make away with himself. As the coroner was making inquests into George's death, the media came to have their own interests. The main heading read, "Has the Devil Captured Brig?" Many Brig folk wrote letters to the newspaper, asking if those who were religious were sacrificing themselves to retain the goodness for Brig. In 1905, suicide became a trend. Within Lincoln, a woman named Harriet Lynn, who decided to bring her life to an end. On a racecourse there she lay dead. Beside her was a note that read, "I am not fit to live with you. I took some aromatic ginger and it caused me this trouble. I hope you will forgive me for this awful deed, but it is too late now.